Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to work with appointments in the .NET MAUI Scheduler and create different types of appointments, such as spanned appointments, all-day appointments, and recurring appointments. Additionally, I will show you how to load appointments on demand for visible dates, how to create appointments for different time zones, and the supported calendar types. I will be continuing with an existing MAUI application that has the necessary namespace and the MAUI scheduler control with data. It also has the event class already bound, which contains information such as event name, start date time, end date time, and background. I have added the custom events in the scheduler view model class. If you want to know how to add the .NET MAUI scheduler to an app with simple list data, watch the Getting Started video linked in the card. You can also download the Getting Started example from the link provided in the description below. Now, I will run the application on an Android emulator. As you can see, the scheduler displays the event appointments in their respective time slots. To make an appointment an all-day event, use its isAllDay property. To illustrate this, let's make the conference appointment an all-day event. First, define a new Boolean property called isAllDay in the event class. Next, set the value of the isAllDay property to true for the conference appointment in the ViewModel class. After that, go to the main page XAML file and map the isAllDay property in the appointment mapping class. Notice here, the conference event is displayed as an all-day event. Next, I will demonstrate how to display spanned appointments in the scheduler. A spanned appointment is an event that lasts longer than 24 hours. To illustrate this, I will change the end time for the general meeting. You will see that the general meeting event spans across 2 days and is rendered on the all-day appointments panel. If you want to repeat appointments at specific intervals, you can use the recurrence rule property along with a valid rule string. This property contains a string value that outlines the frequency of the appointments, such as daily, weekly, monthly, or yearly. It also includes information such as the number of times the appointment should repeat, the duration of the interval, and the time allocated for the appointment. Here, I want to schedule a general meeting appointment that repeats for 10 days. To do this, I first define the recurrence rule property in the event class. Next, I go to the ViewModel class to add the recurrence rule for the general meeting appointment data. I set the frequency to daily, the interval to 1, and the count to 10, so that this appointment will repeat 10 times. Then, I navigating to the main page XAML and map the recurrence rule property. Look here, the general meeting appointment repeats for 10 days in the scheduler. You can create recurring appointments for weekly, monthly, and yearly intervals in a similar manner. Simply set the desired frequency, interval, and count for the appointment you want to repeat. If you need to remove a repeating appointment on specific days, you can use the recurrence exception dates property in the scheduler appointment. By adding exception dates to the recurring appointment, you can remove any occurrence of the appointment on those dates. To demonstrate this, let me remove a recurring appointment that is scheduled for April 26. To do this, I'll go to the event class and define the exception dates property. Next, I move to the ViewModel class to add the exception dates for the general meeting appointment data and add April 26 to its collection. By doing this, I ensure that the recurring appointment is not created for April 26. After that, I'll go back to the scheduler appointment mapping in the main page XAML and map it to the recurrence exception date property. You can see that the appointment is removed from the scheduler view on that date. If you would like to learn more about how to create and manage recurring appointments, you can refer to the documentation link provided in the description for this video. If you want to customize the appearance of appointments in the scheduler, you can use the appointment text style property. To get started, define this property in the scheduler control. And specify the desired text style by setting the text color to black and the font size to 15. You can see that the text color and font size of all appointments in the scheduler are customized. Next, let me show how to load appointments on demand for visible dates in the scheduler. There are two ways to achieve this, using the Query Appointments event or the Query Appointments command. Each is used to improve the appointment fetching performance when rendering current visible dates from a large data source. In this example, I'll be using the Query Appointments event. This event occurs when the scheduler view or visible dates are changed. Before starting, remove the appointment text style code changes. Then, define the Query Appointments event in the scheduler. And navigate to the Event Handler method. Here, I'll create a collection of event names called subjects. And generate random appointments on demand for the visible dates in the view. Finally, I assign these appointments to the Scheduler Appointment Source property. You can see that the appointments are loaded on demand when the view or visible date is changed. Now, I plan to show the Busy indicator when loading appointments in the view. To do this, I'll define the showBusyIndicator property at the beginning of this method and set its value to true. Then, I'll set its value to false after loading the appointments to the scheduler appointment source. To add a delay for appointment loading, modify the method type to async. And set a 1000 millisecond delay for loading appointments. Notice here, the busy indicator is shown while loading appointments in the scheduler. If you would like to learn more about loading on appointments on demand, you can refer to the documentation link provided in the description for this video. Next, I will show how to create appointments in different time zones and display them in their respective time zones or any other time zone in the scheduler. By default, appointments are rendered based on the device's local time zone. To create appointments in different time zones, I define the Start Time Zone and End Time Zone properties in the Event class. Then, I go to the View Model class. Remove the recurrence properties in the General Appointment Data and set the Start Time Zone and End Time Zone to Chicago Time Zone. Once it is set, I move back to the Scheduler Appointment mapping. And map the Start Time Zone and End Time Zone properties. Before running the application, remove the Query Appointments event in the scheduler. You can see that the General Meeting event is now displayed with the Chicago Time Zone as the appointment start and end times are calculated based on the provided time zone information. If you want to display appointments in a specific time zone, you can use the time zone property of the scheduler. For example, I am going to display the appointments in UTC time based on the given scheduler time zone. To do this, define the scheduler time zone property in the View Model class. And set its value to the Brisbane time zone. Further, make sure to remove the Start Time Zone and End Time Zone properties on any appointments. After that, open the main page XAML, define the Time Zone property in the scheduler, and bind its value to the Scheduler Time Zone property in the View Model. You can see that all the appointments will be displayed in the specified time zone in the scheduler. Next, let's see how to specify the calendar types in the scheduler. It supports Gregorian, Korean, Hebrew, and more. The default calendar type is the Gregorian calendar. To change the calendar type, define the calendar type property in the scheduler and set its value to Hijri. Before running the application, remove the time zone property. We can see that the date and time format used in the scheduler changed to reflect the Hijri calendar system. And the flow direction also changed to reflect the right-to-left orientation of the Arabic language. It's important to note that changing the calendar type will not affect the underlying date and time values of the appointments. If you want to learn more about scheduler calendar types, you can refer to the documentation link provided in the description. In this video, I have shown you how to create different types of appointments, such as spanned appointments, all-day appointments, and recurring appointments. I also showed you how to load appointments on demand for visible dates, how to create appointments for different time zones, and the supported calendar types. If you want to see a working example, you can download one from the GitHub link provided in this video's description. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.